So if this bar right over here represents one whole, so the whole thing is shaded in with the purple color, my question to you is, which of these other bars, and it might be more than one of them, represent one half? So our goal is to see one half, is to see one half. So once again, like always, pause the video and try it on your own. Okay, so you've tried it on your own, let's work through it. So if we're thinking about halves, so and we just have one of them, so let me just try to draw another bar here. It would look something like this. I'll try to draw it pretty close to these other bars here. So I would divide it into two equal sections. So two equal sections. And I would only care, or I would be really fill in one of them. That would be one half of this figure. And actually, these sections don't look quite equal. That looks a little bit off. Yeah, that's pretty good. I think you get the idea. That my intent is to draw these to be equal. So then this right over here would be one half. Now, none of these are divided into halves. This one over here is divided into fourths. This one over here is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's divided into fifths. This is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's divided into sixths. This is divided into thirds. So we're going to have to really relate one half to breaking up your whole into different amounts, not just breaking it up into two equal sections, breaking it up into four equal sections, five equal sections, six equal sections, and three equal sections. How do we do that? Well, the easiest thing might be to just break this one up into four equal sections. You break this up into four equal sections. That's just taking each of these two and then breaking those up into two. So that's one equal section and another. Let me use that blue color, actually, because that's my. So that's an equal section right over here. And this is an equal section. So this is the same thing as one half. Notice, I didn't change how much I shaded in. I just divided it into more sections. So we see that one half is the exact same thing as 2 out of 4, as 2 out of 4. Well, how many do we have right over here? We have 1, 2 out of 4. So this is 1, 2 out of 4, and this is 1, 2 out of 4. So 2/4 and 1/2 are the same. These two are equivalent. Now, this might not be obvious, but if you took this block right over here, and if you were to move this one over, and so this one is painted and this one isn't, then they would look the same. So then maybe that would help to see that this also has 1/2 of the block filled in. So this one is definitely half. Now let's think about fifths. Let's think about fifths. So let me, there's two ways I could do it. So let me draw fifths. And this right over here is 3/5, and I might as well just write it down. This is 3/5. This is 3/6, and this is 1/3. But let me draw 3/5 right below this. I keep wanting to change the color, and I'm using a new art tool, and color changing isn't coming as naturally as my old one. So this right over here. So let me divide it into fifths the best I can. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we're going to assume that these are equal sections. I know my drawing is imperfect. But if we have 3/5, where are we going to get to? We're going to get to 1, 2, 3. And one way to think about it, this, what I just drew, is just a rearrangement of this. I just took the three filled in sections and put them all to the left. So I have 1, 2, 3. And when you look at it this way, it's clear that 3/5 is more than 1/2. If we were to try to put the 3/5 onto this one right over here, it would get us about this far. So 3/5 would go all the way over there. So 3/5 is definitely not the same thing as 1/2. Now what about 3/6? 3/6. So let's think about that a little bit. Let me draw another one of these things that I have to keep drawing over and over again. So we already know that if I split this in two equal pieces, I shade in one of them, that's 1/2. This right over here is 1/2. Now can I turn this into sixths? Well, if I take each of these two and I split them into three equal pieces, then I'm gonna have 2 times 6 pieces. So I'm gonna have sixths. So let me do that. So I'm using my blue color. So there you go. And then there you go. I took each of the two and split them into three, and now I have six pieces. Now I haven't changed how much I've shaded in. I've now, but when I think it was one half of the entire bar, but now when I think in terms of sixths, it's 1, 2, 3, 6. 3 sixths is the exact same thing as one half. We have 1, 2, 3, 6. And once again, if you took these two and you shifted them over here, you would get something that looks very much like that or like this. So this right over here is the same thing as one half. Now what about 1/3? 1/3. All right. I think you see where this is going. And always, you should just feel free to pause the video and try to work it on your own. Or frankly, if you get what's going on in the video, you don't have to watch it. All right, so let's divide it into thirds. Let's divide it into thirds. And we're talking about 1/3. We are talking about 1/3 right over here. And very clearly, you see that 1/3 is less than 3/6. And 3/6 is the same thing as 1/2. 1/2 would take you about this far. Would take you that far. 1/3 is less than that. So 1/3 is not equal to 1/2. Hopefully you found that fun.